what is repo rate and what is reverse repo rate. In this video, we will see about what is repo rate and reverse repo rate. It is a very important topic in economy. You should understand it in a better way, then only you can answer some questions which are a little bit tricky. So, okay, let's understand what is repo rate. Repo rate is the rate at which the Reserve Bank of India gives some money, that is for short-term loans, to the commercial banks. So the commercial banks need some money in short term when there is a shortfall of money with their banks. At that time, they will approach the Reserve Bank of India. They will sign some bonds, some government securities, that way at this price I am going to purchase this, so that in future, after the our needs are fulfilled, we will give you back the money with a predetermined rate of interest, which is decided by the RBI, which is called as the repo rate. So it is the interest rate which is charged by the Reserve Bank of India to give money to the commercial banks for short term. That is known as repo rate. And what is reverse repo rate? Reverse repo rate is the reverse of the repo rate, that is the RBI, it's not RBI will borrow money from commercial banks. The commercial banks can deposit their idle money, idle cash, to the Reserve Bank. So then Reserve Bank will give some interest for that deposit to these commercial banks, which is known as a reverse repo rate. Okay, now we will see in depth what is repo rate and reverse repo rate. For repo rate, if you see, the commercial bank is borrowing from the Reserve Bank of India some amount of money, which they will again invest somewhere or give us loans to the public, to the general citizens, the businesses, industries. So if you see, if the repo rate is higher, the repo rate is higher by the RBI, is made higher by the RBI, then it means that the cost to the commercial banks will be high, then the banks will also charge higher interest to the general public, which means that the loans will become more costlier. Now this repo rate can be used to control the inflation and the supply of money. If the cost of getting the loans is very high, then the supply of money will get reduced. Not everyone will get a loan, and there will be some reduction in the supply of money, through which you can control the supply of money. So whenever the RBI wants to control the supply of money in the market, then it will increase the repo rate. Okay, so it is a regulation by RBI to increase or decrease the repo rate. The same way, if it is a reverse repo rate, the thing is that the commercial banks deposit their money with the RBI. When they have excess cash, they can deposit that cash with the RBI, for which the RBI will pay some interest. Now you have to understand that the commercial banks can deposit their money for which they are getting an interest in the form of the reverse repo rate. So if the reverse repo rate is higher, which means that the RBI is giving some amount of interest which is high, then the commercial banks, instead of giving the money to the general public, where if you see them only 2-3% is their profit, instead of giving to the public, they will directly deposit to the RBI and earn some amount for their excess cash. So now you have to understand that with the help of reverse repo rate, the banks, the Reserve Bank of India can also control the level of supply of money. Okay, now here the supply of money gets reduced when the reverse repo rate is higher, and if the reverse repo rate is lower, then the supply of money will increase. You have to understand in this way, you have to do some analysis. I have tried to make you understand the basics of repo rate and reverse repo rate. So RBI will not borrow from the commercial banks, only the commercial banks will deposit when you are understanding about the reverse repo rate. And the same way, repo rate is the rate at which the commercial banks get some money from the RBI for short term needs. So this is what is the reverse repo rate and repo rate. Now you should make some analysis of what can be the consequences when the repo rate is higher, and what can be the consequences when it is lower, and vice versa, and the same in the case of reverse repo rate. So this is what I wanted to make you understand about the repo rate and the reverse repo rate. Hope this was helpful to you. Thank you guys. Keep studying, keep learning.